Hello and thanks for watching. My name is Angel Vilar and I am a technical product manager at VMware. On this video, we are going to see how to achieve two-factor authentication for administrators of NSXT. This video has been released together with a blog post, which you may find also interesting. Let's start by setting some background. NSXT integrates with VMware Identity Manager for remote user authentication and role-based access control. This integration provides enterprise single sign-on across multiple VMware products and advanced authentication methods for NSX, including Active Directory, Radius, Smart Cards, or Secure ID, delivering a seamless authentication experience. I already covered this integration between VMware Identity Manager and NSX in a previous blog and video. What we are going to see now is how to integrate VMware Identity Manager with VMware Verify to provide two-factor authentication for users logging into NSX. VMware Verify is a SaaS service that uses push tokens, so that users get a notification on their mobile devices whenever there is a login attempt using their credentials. And from their mobile device, users can simply accept or deny the login request depending on if it is a legitimate one or not. This way, even if passwords were compromised, attackers would not have access to NSX. This video shows the integration with VMware Verify, but Identity Manager supports additional third-party mechanisms. Please check VMware Identity Manager documentation to get the latest information on this topic. And now it's time for the demo. First, we need to enable VMware Verify inside VMware Identity Manager. For that, we log in to VMware Identity Manager with admin credentials, and then navigate to Identity and Access Management tab, and then select Authentication Methods. Here, we click on the Configure icon next to VMware Verify, where we need to enable the checkbox and enter a security token. We get this security token through VMware or AirWatch support services. Once it's entered, we can click on Save, and now we can see how VMware Verify has been enabled. The second step is to configure a new built-in identity provider. For that, we navigate to the Identity Providers link, we click on the Add Identity Provider button, and select Create Built-in IDP. Now we need to enter a meaningful name describing the identity provider we are creating. In this case, I'm using Built-in IDP VMware Verify. Next, we need to select which users can authenticate using this identity provider. I select the Active Directory that I have set up following the steps from my previous blog. We could also filter from which networks we allow users to authenticate into NSX, but this is not the case here, we allow all ranges. And finally, we select the authentication methods that will be enforced for the users, and I select VMware Verify. Then I click on Add, and my new identity provider has been created. The last configuration step in VIDM is to modify the default access policy. For that, we click on the Policies link, and we click on the Edit Default Policy. Here we scroll down, and for the web browser policy, we click on the hyperlink, and on the next screen we edit the properties. So we select password as the first authentication mechanism, but we add a second one, which is VMware Verify. So users will need to be successfully authenticated using both mechanisms in order to get access to NSX. I remove the fallback authentication option because in case Active Directory or VMware Verify are not available, NSX will be still accessible by using the local NSX user IDs. Once we are ready, we click on OK. And we also need to click on Save to finish our configuration. And actually, this finishes all the configuration we need on VMware Identity Manager. Let's now set up our mobile device. So first we need to go into our application provider and search for VMware Verify. Once we find the app, we download it, which might take a few seconds. And once it is downloaded, we will open it. The first thing the application asks for is our phone number, so we need to select our country for the international prefix and our local phone number. And once we hit on OK, we are also asked for our email address. I'm using one that is only valid in my lab, but typically here you will enter your corporate email address. Once this information is provided, we are presented two different options to get our account verified. Either we are sent a text message with a registration code we need to enter here, or alternatively, we can get a phone call on which we only need to type on the phone pad the registration code we are presented on the screen. I will go to this second option, so I need to wait a few seconds, after which I receive the call, I accept it, and then I type the registration code I was given, 78. This successfully verifies my account, so now the application will move on to the next step, which is to set up a protection PIN. Also, it is important to allow the application to send us alerts so that we are notified whenever there is a login attempt using our credentials. And finally, the application reports that we don't have any accounts yet. This is expected, and this concludes all the configuration we need to do on the mobile device. Let's now try to log into NSX. So we select remote user and click on login, and we are taken to the Identity Manager login page where we need to select our corporate domain. After we click on next, we need to enter our credentials, which is our first authentication factor. Then we are taken to another page where we are asked to enter our phone number details. This happens because this is the first login attempt after setting up the two-factor authentication, and this is required for BIDM to link the user ID with the corresponding mobile number. So let's enter the same mobile number we used before, but also let's bring to the front the recording on the mobile device to see if there are changes during this process. So we enter our phone number ID, and once we are ready we click on sign in, and on the next window we are asked to enter a token from the VMware Verify app, which has started to produce tokens right after we enter the mobile number on the previous login page. So we enter the corresponding token, click on sign in, and finally we will be granted access to NSX after our first successful two-factor authentication. If we go and check the user ID, we can see it's my user ID, the same one that I have configured on my mobile device. Let me now log out from NSX and we will try to log in again to see how subsequent logins are easier than the first one even when using two-factor authentication. Back to the NSX login page, let's click on login, and while we enter our credentials, let me bring to the front the recording on the mobile device. After we click on sign in, we are taken to a new page where we are asked to approve the login request on the mobile application, while on the mobile device itself we get a notification for a pending login request that we need to approve or reject. After I click on approve, the login attempt is allowed and I am finally granted access to NSX again. If we check the user ID, we can see it is the one I use for the credentials and also for configuring the mobile device. And this concludes the demo. Don't forget to check the VMware official channels as well as my personal YouTube channel, where you will find more NSX demos. Thank you.